I am excited to share the latest Home Assistant 2023.10 features and integrations that have landed in the middle of the celebration of Home Assistant's 10th anniversary. Just a quick remark that this is probably the smallest release since a very long time, probably due to the recent holiday season or because of the Home Assistant birthday or due to the announcing of the Home Assistant green device and the new logo, or maybe because all of that, I don't know. Nevertheless, there are some new interesting features that are introduced, so let's give them a look. In the previous releases, a bunch of new features of the tile cart were introduced, especially tailored for climate control. And this time, they're a bit upgraded thanks to some awesome contributions. Now you can add buttons for presets of your climate device right into the tile cart. It is possible to handpick which presets you want to display. Plus, you can now present them in a sleek drop-down list instead of series of buttons. There's even more tile cart updates, as they now have a select feature. This means you can easily choose an option from a list of options. And this is not just limited to select entities, but also work with drop-down helpers, also known as input select entities. Now, let's talk about the map cart, which is the next update. In Home Assistant 2023.10 and onwards, instead of cluttering up the map with every single entity, you can actually customize how each one appears. Before, it would just show the name or a little tag. Now you can choose to display the state, the full name, or even come up with your own custom label. Here is a great example. Imagine you want to know the best gas prices in your area. With this update, the map can now display those prices, making it way more helpful than just a list of names. I think that's pretty cool. Don't you think the same? It is also possible to exclude certain entities from being shown when centering the map. Overall, it's pretty amazing to see these changes in the map cart. This is the first significant update since tracing was introduced a couple of years back. And there is so much potential here. Now let's tackle an issue that's been around for a while. Using password managers with Home Assistant login. You know how annoying it is when your browser wipes out all of your cookies and you have to log in again and you don't remember your Home Assistant password or even your username. Well, that's the headache they've been dealing with in Home Assistant 2023.10. They basically did a major overhaul of the forms system, introducing a fresh template language. So if you are a user of a password manager, you're in for a smoother ride. And of course, there's a bunch of other improvements in this Home Assistant 2023.10 release. Here are a few highlights. ESP Home users gets ready for smaller and faster Home Assistant backups with this latest version. The Roborock integration is expanded with water and last clean sensors. WeThings integration have been remapped for an easier setup and now plays nice with Home Assistant cloud webhooks. Some new integrations are joining the Home Assistant family as well. First is Apple WeatherKit, which allows tracing the weather using Apple's WeatherKit API. EcoForest is also new, IKEA EdaSend Desk, which allows you to connect and control the height of your stand desk. Metcom Bluetooth is now supported, private BLE devices are now supported as well, and this allows tracking of BLE devices with frequently changing MAC addresses. This one is the most interesting to me and I have to further test if it will be able to track my smartwatch. If you happen to know more about that integration, share your wisdom in the comments. SwitchBot Cloud will give you control over your SwitchBot devices using the SwitchBot Cloud API. And finally, Weatherflow integration is also added. Another not bad release packed with features and integrations that can elevate your Home Assistant experience. And if you want to elevate even higher, join my free Home Assistant webinar and download my Smart Home Glossary, which is also absolutely free. Until next time, I'm Kirill. Happy automating. Bye.